various professors and doctors that are here. Private sector players that are here. My lords, spiritual and temporal, that are here. I hope Scabby is here. I say, go work out. Scabby is here. Staff and students of the Polytechnic, Federal Polytechnic UOUG, members of the press, other invited distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me say here that I am not Masoud Kazaure, but I'm Masoud Elebu. We share so many things in common with the Executive Secretary of MDT. Maybe that's why God planned it today that I should be presenting here. His name is Masoud, I'm also Masoud. He read chemistry, I read biochemistry. He was a rector, I was a rector. He was chairman of Council of Heads of Protecting Nigeria, I was also chairman of Council of Heads of Protecting Nigeria. But of course, we don't share the same words. Those of us who are the old school, I'm sure most of my friends here, we used to say, man proposes, God disposes. I want to share this with you. As of 2 days ago on Sunday, because I've been introduced as somebody who is now having his sabbatical leave at MBT. So the executive secretary of MBT is my boss now. I was rector for 10 years at Federal Polytechnic. And only last Sunday, I told him, this week, Wednesday, I will be visiting Ilorin. And I have my tickets, they are still with me, that I have already bought. To leave Abuja today at 3 o'clock, early flight for Ilorin. He now said, probably I should accompany him to this place because our friend director invited all of us. And I said, no, I will not. Rather, I will go to Lorraine to see my old mother, whom I have not seen for 1 month. The women that are here, who are mothers, they know what that means. And he said, okay, we'll go. Only this morning at 7 o'clock, after my prayers, morning prayer, I was sitting down, just sitting down on the praying mat. At 7 o'clock, he called me. And I said, I have no problem because normally I wouldn't put my dark line on until about 8 o'clock. But somehow I put it on. And I said, my Oga, thank you. Something happened? He said, no. That throughout the night, he had been sick. He had headache. And I said, the same thing with me. I had headache throughout the night. Honestly, I couldn't believe it. And I said, have you gone to the hospital? I said, no. I said, I've not gone to you. He said, what did you take? Then I said, I don't know, some of you, probably the imam will know what I'm saying. Some of you are Muslims, yeah? Zamzam water. There's this Zamzam water. Maybe those of all my Christian brothers will say holy water. Zamzam water from Mecca. And I told him that's what I took. And he said, do you have some? I said, yes, I have some relief. Then I said, he said, you have some at home. I said, take some, you have some relief. Then I said, by the way, when are you going to be on the road? So I will come to Abuja and you take off. My own flight, 3 o'clock. And he said, my brother, that's why I called you. I said, why, sir? He said, you'll not go to that university. I'm not what? To see my mother? He said, no, you have to go to the university. I said, but I told you that I will not be chance. He said, no, he was not fit at that time. He said, he wasn't fit enough embarked on the journey. And you really want a situation where you collapsed. But because I told him that I was feeling better because of what I took, I should proceed. So that's why I found myself crying. And we started making arrangements. He now said, he had a ticket. I said, well, I don't have a ticket. He said, okay, go take some money. I said, I don't have ATM. I'm of the old school. Yes, I don't have any ATM. I don't need an ATM card. I told him, he said, yes, he told me. I want to use MasterCard when I travel out of the country. But I don't use ATM. I have my checkbook. And he said, Tom, today it has come to it. You have to go. Somehow, we find a way out. So let me try. I call the people who booked Ari for me. So okay, contact over now, go to Akure, see if I can get a seat, and so on. So, and then reply, no seat for Akure today, fully booked. So whatever it takes, I call him and say, whatever it takes, you have to go. And that's why I'm here. But honestly, before I go into the lecture proper, coming to this place is worth it. For our brother and our friend, Professor Fasaki. He knows what I'm saying about. We have been involved in the struggling. We saw the way it was running, helter skelter, up and down, to bring this school to what it is today. Several times we have met at TED Forum. He's here. And we jokingly tell him, say, you politician. That's what he used to call me, and he still calls me. Help me with executive telephone. I want my takeoff grant. I want this, and so on and so forth. And we say, hey, slow down. But that's what it takes for somebody who has a vision, who is focused, and who wants to help society. Today, I was surprised with with what I've seen. I said, within this short time, how come? And he said, they are not taking me to some other places, the other campuses. So it's worth it coming to this place. But I must also say that various occasions, which I've also had, including convocation and meetings for co-heads, which I had the opportunity of hosting in my former place of work as rector, Professor Fasaki attended. Very well, participated very well. And so we are indeed, and I am indeed particularly very happy to be here. And I'm indeed very happy to represent the Executive Secretary of MBT. And all what I've said here, he would have said more than that as regards Professor Fasaki and the institution. We want to thank you immensely for inviting the MBT to this place. I will, of course, read what is here. And whatever it is here, don't hold me responsible for it. Although I say we share so many things in common. But I must also say that I'm so much impressed, not with only what I see, the infrastructure, but there's something that I got fascinated by. When the Polytechnic anthem was being sung, the council member, the old like myself, the old lady, I don't know her name, please pardon me, but she was introduced as a council member. She sang it's very near. Like I said, I've served as rector for 10 years. It's very rare for you to find a council member singing the anthem of the institution. That is the truth. I'm talking from experience. And even within 2-3 years, for this institution to have a council, to have an anthem, is something very important. Let me share this with you. Kwara State Polytechnic was established in 1973. 1970, over 40 something years now. Kwasi Polytechnic only got an anthem 2013 when I got there. 2013. Because I insisted they are more serious than me. So we are only to have an anthem within 3-4 years. That shows the kind of person, the kind of stuff that the director is made of. Congratulations. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me not bother you with frivolities, but I think some of these things I've mentioned are very important. I'll go straight to this lecture. This is a lecture at the maiden convocation ceremony of Federal Polytechnic in Ileoluchi, Odo State, by M.A. Kazaro MNI. The title of the topic is Building a Globally Competitive Higher Institution, the Role of Stakeholders. These students have come at a better time than now. And I think this particular topic has been chosen deliberately because of the role the stakeholders are playing or we want them to play in the evolution of this polytechnic. I've had somebody from the hospital, somebody from this, and so on and so forth. So the topic has been deliberately chosen. As we are stepping into this space, I asked the rector, are you awarding fellowship of this polytechnic to anybody today? And in his usual self, he categorically told me no, that it's not cheap. We must see the contribution of an individual before we give him the fellowship. So, good individuals, the stakeholders of course. And so, we need to look at what role should the stakeholders play in the life of this polytechnic. And that's why we have this particular lecture. So I'll read it. And where it says I, it means the executive secretary, not me. It means the other Masu, the senior Masu, not the junior Masu. It goes this way. Thank you, Rector, for the invitation and opportunity to speak at this very important occasion. The ES feels that there is no other person to speak on their whole topic rather than the ES himself. The paper is not going to be fully academic. Like I've been told, the ES is an astute administrator. And today, if you want to, our higher institutions, it's not only academics, but administration comes in. So, you should not expect the usual quotations and references, and then you walk out, and then people begin to look at their dictionary and so on and so forth. Rather, the ES will talk purely from his personal experiences and official communications. The Federal Polytechnic in Ileoluchi is one among the four Federal Polytechnics created on the 5th of June, 2014. The history of the establishment of the Polytechnic started when the ES met Governor Mimiko at the airport and was introduced to ES by Governor Nelson Wike, the then Honorable Minister of Education. Nothing happened thereafter until when His Excellency Senator Ibrahim Shekaro was appointed as Honorable Minister of Education for Education. Thereafter, on the 25th of March 2015, the letter of appointment of principal officers of this polytechnic was forwarded to MBT, and the MBT was requested to take further necessary action to ensure successful takeoff of the new polytechnic. The rector, Professor Fasaki, organized a meeting between the ES and Governor Mimiko and the ES at Ondo State Abuja Liaison Office, Abuja, There was serious discussion on how the development of the polytechnic was going to be tailored. In other words, building a globally competitive federal polytechnic at IOUG was the focus and was the topic that was discussed. After the meeting, Governor Mimiko said then he regretted not to have known the ES much earlier than that time. That means he enjoyed the discussion, and the discussion was very fruitful, and he learned a lot from him. On Monday, the 4th of May 2015, the Honorable Minister of Education then, Mala Ibrahim Shekau, visited for the takeover, handover of the polytechnic temporary and permanent sites. People in the entourage included Director of Tertiary Education, Federal Minister of Education, and Executive Secretary MBT. There were other important stakeholders of the then ruling party. Level has changed now. We're on the next level now. The technical committee was thereafter sent from the Federal Minister of Education and MBT to ensure there was no encumbrances in the sites. On the 8th of April 2014, the ES wrote to the Budget Office of the Federation and the Captain General of the Federation requesting inclusion of the school in the 2014-2015 fiscal budget. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is important to highlight some of this, because when we are talking of building something, the foundation is important. And some of these things that have been highlighted represent the foundation